DNA computing uses DNA and other biological molecules instead of silicon-based computer technologies. In 1994, Professor Leonard Edelman of the University of Southern California published a paper in Science. He's a mathematician, but he realized the potential of DNA computing when he spent a summer doing molecular biology. The title of this proof of concept work was Molecular Computation of Solutions to Combinatorial Problems. He demonstrated a use of DNA as a form of computation to solve a Hamiltonian path problem. The Hamiltonian path problem is a classical mathematics problem. It is also called the traveling salesman problem. Let's consider a simplified example. Suppose that a salesman starts from Los Angeles and needs to visit all these three cities, Dallas, Chicago, Miami, before his final destination, New York. The airline he has a mileage membership with has a limited number of connecting flights. These. What is the best itinerary? That since this is simplified, it's easy to figure out. Starting from Los Angeles, he needs to fly to Chicago, then Dallas, Miami, and then to New York. This is the best one. You don't need the help of a computer. However, if the number of cities increases, for example, 30 cities, the problem won't be manageable with our brain. How can you solve this problem with DNA? The first thing we need to do is to encode each city by a 6-nucleotide DNA sequence. So for example, Los Angeles is GCTACG, Dallas is TCGTAC. How can we encode available flights? We can encode the flights between cities by using complementary sequence of the second half of the departure city and the first half of the arrival city. Let me show you. For example, the flight between Miami and New York can be designed as GCCTAC, which connects Miami and New York. The random itineraries can be made by mixing city encodings with the flight encodings. Finally, the DNA strands can be connected together by an enzyme called ligase. You get many different DNA sequences, many different DNA combinations. Then you purify the DNA starting with Los Angeles and ending with New York from the mixture. Then finally, you purify the shortest DNA, which should represent for a shortest itinerary. Then this is actually it. This is an interesting way to use DNA. Since the initial Edelman's experiment, a number of work have been carried out. This work was a beginning of DNA computing.